I should stop drinking and get the red rose from the abandoned house in the village. I want to commemorate my husband next to his grave, but first I need to tidy my home up a little. Let's start from the dirty windows. Now fix the alignment of pictures. Okay then. Before I leave, I need to look around if I miss something. After all, I am going on an adventure. Who knows? Of course, my pills! Now let's put on the boots and get going. How I wish I could run, but impossible for me with the high heels. Can chickens swim? I asked him in a drizzly dawn. Of course, he replied. They can run into water and stay there as much as they want to. How come? I wondered. He laughed and told me that it depends how realistic the developer scripts the AI for the chicken. Years later, I played a game called Drizzlepath and finally got what he meant by that. Me and my sister Lara visited him at the morgue. He was just lying without fear of the past. Suddenly, all our memories came to life when I was close to him again. But it was different. He wasn't trying to make me smile like he always did. Maybe he was watching me, trying to tell me something about our last day together. Maybe he was angry about the mistakes I did. I saw him struggling the consequences of ignorance, and I came close to him and whispered, "It is over." There used to be seaplanes flying around our town. We often enjoyed watching them near the ocean. Eric mentioned that some of them were float planes. I laughed and said they are both the same things. "Nope," he disallowed. "There is a difference. Float planes have pontoons to take off or land on. Their body isn't intended to touch the water." He loved to make me feel ignorant, but I always sorted out by not talking to him for the rest of the day. Then again, he knew how to make me generous one way or another. Oh, my head. I need to take a pill. Foxes are major predators of hens, but when it comes to humans, they sometimes act as simple pets. If Eric were here now, he would act the guardian angel in such an unnecessary way. Sometimes he treated me like his little girl, with no teeth on her mouth. Getting help from him learning to drive was great pain because of his obsessions about trying to keep me secure. Now that he's not around, I miss everything about him. Even the least pleasing sides of his character make me sensitive. In order to open the sacred passage, I must fill this urn with blood. Should be able to find 3 amphoras filled with blood in this cave. There! I got all 3! Time to dive!
Thank you.
It was a Sunday morning. I was going to clean the floor, but he took away the vacuum cleaner and threw out the window.
Why?
I asked, my hands shaking.
It will be better there outside as an Easter egg, he said. Somebody will find it and never understand its purpose being there.
That was so cryptic of him. I never found out what he meant. But it was definitely the first weird moment of our marriage. Wind has effect on mechanical elements, just like it has effect on water. I like to swim, but when I get out of water, and if it is windy, it makes goosebumps and feels awful. Why am I telling this? I must focus on grabbing the red rose. It should be in the abandoned house. But where was the house? Somewhere in the village that I'm getting near. But which house was it? I guess I must try all the doors. They all lock their doors in this hour, but I should be able to open the one door. There's the village. The rose is in one of those houses. I should check their doors.
can't open it. Stuck. Locked. Can't open it. Stuck. This should help me open the box upstairs. Okay, now I'll grab the rose and leave. What is happening?